Yeah.
Call all the deacons up.
Call them up now.
Ask if we linking up.
Ask if we linking up.
What time no sleeping time?
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 Call up the deacons, bro.
Call them up now.
Ask if we linking up.
Ask if we linking up.
What time no sleeping time?
What time no sleeping time?
Wake up the sleeping tribe.
Wake up the sleeping tribe.
Call up the deacons, bro.
Call them up now.
Ask if we linking up.
Now, 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 now.
What time no sleeping time?
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 Call all the deacons up.
Call them up now.
Ask if we linking up.
What we linking up?
What time no sleeping time?
I said I had to call him up. I made the phone call a deke like, what's up, is you ready for war? He replied, being ready for war, being ready for a battle with swords. And I respect him cause he fought many wars. I humble down to what the scriptures say and give doubles to the elders that been leading the way. I know it's hard in this walk and they've been walking for years. So when I'm weak in the flesh, they voice it into my ears. A young man trying to soak the wisdom, gain the knowledge, apply the scriptures. Wrong decisions leave me senseless. Dear Lord, would you give me a chance? We all looking for the code.
Dressing military. We didn't come out here to play games with our people. We come out here to play people. to get out of this condition. First of all, to understand how to get out of the condition, you gotta understand how you got in the condition.
Oh, yeah, right.
So what I'm gonna show you now is how we got in this condition.
We're going to
Deuteronomy chapter 28, Deuteronomy 11 and 26.
Bring it up!
Bring it out!
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 11 and verse 26.
I want all y'all to hear this. I want y'all to understand how did the black man and the black woman, Hispanic man, Hispanic woman, get in such a low condition on earth. Everybody got the solution, but nobody goes to the Bible to see what the solution is. I can sit here and talk to you about how we're going to fix the crime. But let's see what God says, how we got in this predicament, to understand how to get out of it. How you doing, sir? I am listening to this right quick. You feel tired right quick? Okay, listen. What I'm showing is how we got in this predicament as a black man. All right? What I'm going to give you is your true nationality before you die.
That's right.
If I ask you your nationality, what can you tell me? Okay, African American is not nowhere in the Bible. Okay, so I want you to understand this. We've been taught we was African American in the slave.
That's right.
You know when they started calling black people African American in 1984. Jesse Jackson was the first person with the word Africa in America.
Bring it out.
The word Africa comes from a white man named Scipio Africano.
Right.
He come from Hannibal in the Second Punic War and he named the land Africa. The word America comes from a white man named Amerigo Vespucci.
That's right, man. Right.
He come to this land and named it America. So you come from two white men, so you're not African American.
That's right. Right.
Look at this sign right here. Y'all see y'allself on this sign?
Bring it up.
I am a child.
You are the child of Judah.
Yes. Right.
American black. The Indian black, the Haitians, Ephraim, Puerto Rican, all these people are the same people, okay? But we were scattered from the corners of the earth on the transatlantic slave trade. And they came and got us out of the coast of Africa, okay? The white man knew they were gonna get.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 6. I said before you this day.
So God told the Israelites, he said, behold, I'm going to set before you this day
a blessing.
He's going to put before the Israelites a blessing
and a curse.
And a curse. So he's going to put two sides. You either get a blessing or you can get a curse. Right? Look what God told the Israelites. I'm showing you how we know that you are from the tribe of Israel. We are the greatest thing God
created. If ye obey the commandments of the Lord your God.
He said a blessing if we obey the commandments of God.
Which I command you this day. And a curse.
He said, well, you're going to get a curse.
But if ye will not obey the commandments of the Lord your God.
And we don't obey God, we're going to be cursed.
But turn aside out of the way which I command you this day to go after other gods.
So that's what happened. We got turned out of the way of God. God got angry at us. And he delivered us on captive. On cargo slave ships, and what? Now we have turned to other gods.
Bring it on!
If we ask any little children, a child out here right now, who is this?
What?
You know who they gonna say?
Jesus.
They gonna say Jesus.
That's right.
So we got turned to another god. Let's see what the God of the Bible looks like. And we're gonna show you what Jesus looks like.
Bring it out!
Hey, I'm gonna show y'all.
Bring it out!
I know kids don't wanna hear this. No, I want y'all, hold on. She got more questions.
No, I'm
kidding. Hold on, hold on, hold on. I want you, because you want the foundation. I want you to get it. It's raining. I know you feel that why don't get fooled off by what we say. Don't let what we say appear. Because anything I say, I'm gonna prove it out the Bible. Lay the concrete down on land that I don't want you to leave in the middle of while we churn it. Okay, watch this. This right here, y'all don't believe. Hold it up. So everybody can see it. This the root of black on black crime. Y'all wonder why people get killed and shot in Jackson? Because of this picture right here. Behind this picture comes a doctor.
What?
And behind this picture, the white man had taught you that he's God. And you can do whatever you want to do.
Bring it up.
All you gotta do is call on the name of Jesus. That ain't what the Bible says.
Right.
First, I'm gonna show you what Jesus looked like. Give me Revelation chapter 1.
Bring it out. Revelation chapter 1 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
Listen, the revelation of Jesus Christ.
So this is the revealing of Jesus Christ.
Come on.
We're gonna show you that Jesus Christ is not a white boy.
That's right.
This is very important for you young black women.
What?
You need to know that your Lord is saved. is a black man.
That's right.
Because you look in the world now, the black woman is running to the white man for rest, for refuge. White man, save me. Let me get some of your money.
Bring it out.
Read what you got.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1.
Bring it out.
Revelation of Jesus Christ.
So this is the revealing of Jesus Christ. Give me verse 13. Hold for a month right there.
Verse 10.
All right, I want y'all to understand something. Read.
I was in the spirit on the Lord's day.
So he was in the spirit on the Lord's day. Read.
And heard behind me a great voice.
So if you heard behind you a great voice, what you gonna do? You gonna turn around.
Read. As a trumpet saying, I am Alpha.
So he said, he's the Alpha, bro. Listen, pay attention. Christ is the Alpha.
And Omega.
And he's the Omega.
The first and the last.
He is the first and the last.
What thy sins write in a book.
Why would he tell him to write it in a book? A lot of people say, well, nobody's seen Jesus. If he fed, if he 5,000 people, somebody had to see him. If a woman touched the hem of his garment, somebody had to see him. Guess what? John the Revelator see him. He said in his hand,
what thy sins write in a book.
He told him to write down what you see, because they already knew that somebody else was going to talk about another Jesus.
And send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia.
Verse 14.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
It said his head and his hairs were white like wool.
Bring it out. As white as snow.
Okay, so stop right there. So if they telling our children that this is Jesus, read that part again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Do we got hair like wool? I need the black woman to bring their kids over here and listen.
Bring it out.
I said, does he have hair like wool? That's not Jesus.
Bring it out.
Guess who got hurt like wool, bro?
I do.
You do.
That's right.
So why you do, sister? What? You do, sister? So where in the world they keep telling us that this Jesus?
Bring it up.
You believing it. It said his hair and his head was white like wool. Just like this brother head. It's turning white. He's getting older. He's getting wisdom.
But read. His head and his hair were white like wool.
Breathe.
As white as snow.
It's going to turn white as snow as he keep living. Breathe.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
It said his eyes was a flame of fire. What color is this boy's eye? What color is his? Hold that picture up. You see how we just took the picture? We ain't saying it's Jesus now. We just took the picture out of the Bible and made our own description.
Bro,
the white man is slave and gave you his description.
That's right.
He said his hands were white like wool. He said his eyes was a flame of fire.
Bring it up.
What color is his eye?
Teach.
A flame of fire. Why was his eyes a flame of fire? Read it.
The book of Genesis chapter 49 and verse 12.
Read it.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
God, read that one more time.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
What was Jesus Christ's eyes red? Because he drunk wine.
Right.
He was a wine bibber. Right. His first miracle was what? Turning water and wine.
Read it.
Christ said, man, it ain't enough going on right here. Bam, he turned water into wine and they got it popped.
That's right.
That's what happened. All right, go back to Revelation.
His eyes were as a flame of fire.
Uh-huh.
And his feet like a
torch. Hold on. Read that again.
His eyes were as a flame of fire.
Okay.
And his feet.
And he's looked down at Jesus Christ's feet, little sister. You take off your shoes, your feet is going to be the same color as your rest of your body.
That's right.
So he looked down at Jesus' feet and it what?
His feet was like a fine brass.
He said his feet was like fine brass. I'm gonna ask you what color is brass.
Oh, brown.
It's brown.
Yeah.
So he had her wool, eyes red as fine, and his feet was like fine brass.
What
color is his? What color is his skin?
Pale white.
Yeah, it looked white, but it really ain't white.
Right.
It's really red.
Yes.
That's why we call him red next.
Yes.
I'm gonna show you that in the Bible. Read.
And his feet like a too fine brass,
uh-huh.
As if they burned in a furnace.
No, but it says as if they what?
Burned in a furnace.
If they burned in the furnace, so if you throw anything in the furnace, what color does it come out? What color does it come out if you burn it? It's gonna come out black.
Yes.
Even though it was the same color as this brother right here.
Yes.
The same color with white hair.
Yeah.
The only thing different, Jesus had a beard on his face. He never shaved his face.
Right.
So, give me me Daniel. He wanted to read the one. Let me show you in the Old Testament, in the book of Daniel, what Jesus looked like. I'm telling you, man, this is the root. White man know the image plays a part in everything.
That's right.
What? If I don't see Jesus in you, guess what? I'll call you a nigga and gun you down.
That's right.
But if I see Jesus in you, guess what? I'm not finna pull a gun out on you.
Right.
I'm not finna break your house.
First, right.
I'm not finna have sex with your daughter without
right.
consent from you to marry her.
That's right.
Because I see Christ in you.
But yeah.
Well, guess what? The white man has said he's Christ, and he said that we are niggas.
Freedom.
When they teach us like niggas, guess what? That's why I shoot you down in the street.
That's right.
That's my nigga right there.
Bring it out.
I don't really love my nigga. I'ma shoot my nigga. Alright? Alright? So I want you to understand that. I wish I had time to answer y'all questions. Alright? This knowledge coming out, I wasn't nothing in the world can stop me from hearing it.
What?
Then you gonna walk off in the rain?
Bring it up!
Man, they crazy.
Bring it up!
That's how you know it's safe.
Yeah.
Hey, give me where are you at? Let me show you what Daniel looked like.
So y'all
know this ain't Jesus now, right? Y'all know this ain't Jesus. Y'all ignore all y'all life. Give me John 8:32.
Bring it up!
See, don't nobody care about the Bible until somebody gets shot in your family.
Yes, right.
Until tragedy land on your doorstep, that's when you want to cry out to God.
Yes, right.
Why they killed my baby?
Bring
because you would not listen to God.
Yeah,
because you wanted to do what you wanted to do. God gonna kill you. God got something for every last one of you who do not want to listen to His word.
Yeah, the book of John, chapter 8 and verse 32.
Bring
ye shall know the truth.
The Bible says that you black folk, y'all gotta know the truth.
Why? And the truth shall make you free.
See, the truth is what's gonna make us free.
That's
a lie. That's a lie. Now I'm saying you free by giving you what? The truth.
That's right. What?
Give me Jeremiah chapter 60 and verse 10, I think. Man, we ain't out here to play games. We gonna bring out the word in the rain.
What?
But after rain at the same time. When it start raining, we gonna go back out.
That's right.
Man, y'all, hey, we all up here in Notre Dame. We sit the Bible school.
16 and 10.
I told after these 2 weeks. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 16 and verse 10.
Read it.
It shall come to pass.
The Bible said it shall come to pass.
But thou shalt show his people all these words.
It said when you shall show these people all these words in the Bible, the true word of God.
And they shall say unto thee.
That's what y'all gonna say unto us.
Read it. Therefore have the Lord pronounced all these great evils against us.
Why is crime in our neighborhood? Why is the black woman aborting our children?
Read it.
That's what y'all gonna start asking.
Read. Oh, what is our iniquity?
What have we done? What is our sin, God?
Read on. Or what is our sin that we have committed against the Lord our God? Then shall thou say unto them, because your fathers have forsaken me.
Read it slow, bro.
Then shall thou say unto them.
So that's what we gonna say unto them.
Read on. Then shall thou say unto them,
that's what we gonna say unto them,
because your fathers have forsaken me,
but our forefathers have forsaken God,
said the Lord, and have walked after other gods.
See, y'all don't walk after other gods and not even
bring it out.
Y'all don't join Greek letter organizations and walk after other gods and don't even know it.
Right.
You don't walk after the white man as your God.
Right.
The white man ain't God.
Bring it out.
The white man is the devil that the Bible speaks.
Yeah.
It's time for our people to wake up, stop killing one another, and recognize that we are kings of this.
Right.
We are the true people of God.
That's right.
We are the real Jews.
Bring it out.
Right. We are the real Jews.
That's right.
The rain ain't gonna stop y'all from hearing the word of God today.
That's right.
Let the word of God run you off.
Bring it out.
Give me Proverbs chapter 28 and verse 1, because I know some people say, Lord, let's go.
Bring it out.
They read the Bible, honey. Let's go.
Hey.
Bring it out. Run them off and read them out, then I'm going to church tomorrow, which is not the Lord's day.
That's right.
You're going to learn lies.
That's right.
You're going to get a church tomorrow, you're going to get a feel good sermon. And the Lord says, Jesus, bring me your money.
Bring it out.
Bring it out. And you're going to sit up there and take them your money.
Right.
Bring it out. It's time for our people to wake up and stop killing one another.
That's right.
Read.
mad and don't want to hear the word of God.
Right.
Give me Zephaniah chapter 7 and verse 11. You're looking at the army of God, y'all. You're looking at a new breed of black men.
That's right.
We got jobs, we got wives,
right.
We take care of our kids.
That's right.
See, y'all ain't used to seeing this. And we were over here gangster walking. And your guy was over here. What's the dude to do the little piece there? What's the new dude?
Eli.
Block, what's up with your name?
What you say?
Hey, and we want these rappers, we your guy over here, y'all have all y'all kids over here doing the name. But since the word of God come now, y'all take y'all kids away from God. That's why I gonna be some murder and some killing and some twerking and some teenage pregnancies in your neighborhood.
That's
Zechariah chapter 7 and verse 11.
Bring
out!
They refuse. See, y'all refuse the word of God. Listen.
Too hungry.
Y'all refuse to listen to God.
And pull away thy shoulders.
Y'all pull away y'all shoulders from the Bible.
What?
Y'all don't want to hear that. I want to keep working. I want to quit. I want JoJo to keep running up into me until he gets me pregnant and bounce.
Bring it out!
I want to just keep listening to rap music until my brother killed my cousin. The rap music until they set it off in the club tonight.
Bring it
out. Y'all refuse to hearken to God. Listen.
What?
And pull away the shoulder.
Y'all pull away y'all shoulders to God's word, and God got, his eyes are 10,000 more times brighter than the sun.
That's right.
Bring.
And stop their ears.
They do what?
They stop their ears.
Girl, I know it's kind of springing, but we gonna keep on going. They read the Bible. Y'all stopping y'all ears to the word of God. Listen.
What? That they shall not hear.
That y'all don't want to hear the word of God. Listen.
Yeah, they made their hearts as an adamant stone.
Y'all making y'all minds as an adamant stone, meaning y'all hard.
Hurry up.
That's how you know we God chose the people, because he said, y'all Negroes is hard-headed.
Right.
Y'all don't want to hear the word of God.
Right.
Y'all do not want to hear the word of God until, guess what? Somebody gets shot.
Right.
You get killed.
Right.
You want to pray to God.
Yeah,
but God is not going to hear your prayer.
Bring it out.
How you doing, sister?
She's interested.
Okay, come around here. Let me show you something. This is because we got a display. We need you to understand this to see.
What?
I'm going to first command you on how you dress, sister.
That's right.
Okay?
All right.
Come on, sister, around the block. All the women out here, you dress nice.
That's right.
Okay? You got your husband?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. You keep dressing like that, guess what? He gonna find you.
That's right!
Listen.
Yeah, they made their hearts as an adamant stone.
What?
These they shall hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in the spirit by the former prophets.
Okay, so what you're hearing now is the word of God, okay?
No.
You believe in the Bible? Okay, so I wanna ask you something. See yourself on this sign right here. I want y'all to come look. Y'all go to the lane.
Take good.
Okay, you look. Okay. Alright, so you see yourself on this sign right here.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna give you your true nationality. Like if I ask all three of y'all right now, I'm gonna ask you personally. What's your nationality? Yeah. American. What's your nationality? African American, that's two. We're gonna gain two different ones already. Okay, all praise. We're going to show you the prophecy that you wasn't going to know, and that you all do not know your nationality. Give me Jeremiah right there.
Bring it up!
Hey, this is Bible prophecy, what I'm showing our people.
Bring it up!
Alright? We're not American.
What?
Okay? We were brought here on a cargo slave ship, and we were taught religion. What made you an American? You're not African American because the word Africa comes from a white man named Scipio Africanus. He conquered Hannibal in the Second Punic Wars, and he named the land of Africa after himself. The word America comes from a white man named Amerigo Vespucci. Okay, he conquered this land, all right? Took the Native American Indians, stuck them off in a bathroom somewhere, killed them all, and said, this is now called America. So you come from two white men?
Bring it up!
Ain't no way two white men can't make nothing.
What?
Yeah, let me see those pictures right there. I'll pray you. Alright, this is a white man right here. Hold it right quick. This is Scipio Africanus right here.
What?
He the one coming to Hannibal. Alright, this is where the name Africa comes from, a white man. America Vespucci. this ugly white man right here. Bring it out. I'm say you come from him.
Bring it out, huh? Right? Bring it out.
For real, check that out, all right? I want you to understand something. Read this.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, and verse 4. Thou, even thyself.
I said, and thou, what's your name, sister? Ariana, Aaliyah, and Diane. I want you to understand what the Bible said. How you doing back there in the back, sister? What's your name?
Ariana.
Hold on.
Ariana.
Now, sister.
Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 4.
Read
and thou even thyself.
It said, and thou even yourself, Ariana, Ariana, I'm here, right? Read.
Shall discontinue from thy inheritance.
Now, we was going to discontinue from our heritage. You understand that? We was going to discontinue from the Bible.
That's right.
Read.
That I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve.
And he was going to cause us to serve
thine enemy.
Our friends.
Thine enemy.
No, our buddies.
Thine enemies.
So he's going to cause us to serve our enemies
in the land which thou knowest not.
He's going to cause us to serve our enemies in the land that we do not. So what? What? Where are we at? We're not home, so we're in our enemy's land.
That's right.
All right, listen.
In the land which thou knowest not. For ye have kindled a fire in my anger.
Okay, we kindled a fire in God's anger. Understand that. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 1.
Freedom!
Let me show you how we know that you are not American black, but you are from the tribe of Judah.
That's right!
Judah means God's praise. We are the greatest thing God created. Creatures, God created.
That's right!
The white man is not the real Jew. You and I are the real Jews.
That's right!
Okay? They say they Jewish, meaning they wish to be you.
That's right, bring it out!
Y'all probably know. So if I put ISH as a suffix on the word, what does that mean?
Partial.
Partial? Right. Pertaining to?
Right.
Like I can say, your shirt ain't black, it's blackish. It's not really black. Your shirt blue, but it's bluish.
Right.
So they say they the Jews, but they Jewish.
Yeah,
that's so that means right. They not the real Jews.
Yeah, right.
The real Jews are you. I'm going to show it to you. Listen.
Bring it out.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 1.
Bring it out.
And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
It said if we hearken. It means if we listen to God, sister. Read.
To observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day.
It said it's the Israelites, the Jews, the people on this side. Do all that God commands him, read.
That the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
So he was going to set these people above all nations on the earth.
That's right.
Now, there's a flip side to it. Just like you got children. You got children, sister, Diane? Okay, you have children. You tell your children to do something. You say, look, when I get out of work, clean your room. Hey, you graduate, go to school, go to college. What you going to do for them? You're going to stand beside them, you're going to reward them, right? But if they don't do what you say, do what you're going to do.
Don't say that.
Bring it up.
You're just being grown, nigga.
No, what if they're children?
They're children.
Yeah, they're going to be punished.
That's
so I want you to
right.
understand something. Dad, we are God's chosen people. We are his children.
Right.
Now I'm going to read you the flip side. He said, if we do what he say do, he's going to send us above all nations. Okay? Man, we keep reading on that 28 and 2, I think.
Verse 2, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, and if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So he said, if we do what he said, then he's going to bless us.
Right.
Okay, we want to say we blessed, but we're going to show you that we're not blessed. Okay?
That's right.
All right? Read.
Yeah.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Now, remember the flip side. Remember, I asked you, if they don't do what you say, then listen.
But it shall come to pass. If thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God,
he said, if we don't listen to God, if we do not listen to God,
to observe to do all his commandments,
if we don't observe to do all his Bible, read,
and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So he said all these curses instead of blessings. Now, you're going to get what? You're going to get curses. All right? Read.
Curse shall thy be in the city.
So the first curse, he said, look, y'all don't want to do what I say, look. God said, curse you gonna be in the city. Y'all from Jackson?
Yeah.
Where you from?
Originally.
You're originally from Memphis. Where you from? Haytown, Missouri. Little Rock, Arkansas. And Jackson. All right, now I want y'all to read this again. I mean, listen to this again, listen.
Cursed shall thy be in thy city.
He said, so if you can go to Haytown, Missouri, Little Rock, Memphis, Jackson, the Israelites gonna be there cursed.
Word.
All right? Chicago, California, Beijing, China. If you're an Israelite, you're gonna be there cursed.
Word. You're
gonna be at the bottom of society.
Right.
First fight, last height.
That's right.
Bring it up.
Way high. Abortion clinics all in your neighborhood. It said that you was gonna be cursed in the city and where?
Like I said, cursed shall I be in the field.
You gonna be cursed in the field. I want y'all to look at this. You see the bottom down here?
Bring it up.
Gonna be cursed in the field. What field will we curse in? Somebody probably already done got shot. The sugar cane field.
Right.
We were cursed. And God said, for our disobedience, these things were going to happen to us. Alright? He said, cursed we were going to be in the city, and cursed we were going to be in the field. Give me verse 46 right quick. This is the greatest knowledge on earth, and that's who we are according to God. Ain't nobody going back to the Bible to find who we are. That's why we don't know where we at, and as a people, we don't know where we going. This is not an individual thing.
Bring
it up. You understand that? We came over here on a slave ship together, guess what? We gotta survive together.
That's right.
All right, listen.
Verse 46, and they shall be upon thee.
He said, and these curses was gonna be upon us.
For a sign?
For a sign. What does a sign tell you? Where to go? It tells you where you at. We know we at Hayes and Lexington because of what? That sign.
What?
We know we at Hayes Food Express because of that sign.
What?
God is telling you that these curses was gonna be on his chosen people for a sign.
And for a wonder.
And a wonder. You gonna wonder why you go through what you go through.
And upon thy seed.
Upon the seed. You know what the seed is? The children. So all the way back when Moses was reading this, all the way up until 2017, we can relate to this Bible.
That's right. And upon thy seed forever.
Forever. Give me verse 32. What I'm reading you is the curses. Hey, how you doing? I'm reading you the curses, how we know that we are the chosen people of God.
Word.
Because he said, if you do what I say do, I'm going to bless you. If you don't do what I say do, I'm going to what? I'm going to curse you.
That's
here's
right.
Another curse. Listen.
Verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given into another people.
He said, for your disobedience, our sons and daughters will be given into another people. When did that happen to us? In slavery, you see it right here.
Bring it out.
Yes. See, now
bring
y'all telling a fine young buck right there. A black woman don't think you need your soul either. They just want you to pick a man. Alright? You see that? They selling them. Alright? That was a curse from God. You wonder, how did the white man know to come get us out of all the people? We was gonna make such a great kingdom. We was gonna build up a kingdom 300 and some years for free.
Bring it out!
How did they know to come get us? Because we are the same people that was in Egypt.
But
Moses sent Aaron. And told when God sent Moses and Aaron and told Pharaoh to let my people go.
That's
those
right.
Were not white people they was coming to get.
Right.
They was coming to get us.
That's right.
That's how they knew to come get you and pack you on a slave ship. Because God know, they know that we are the greatest thing. That's why they want to be like you. They want to dress like you. They want to wear their hair like you. They want to wear their skin like you. They want to do everything like you, sing like you, run like you.
Right. Whatever. Bring it up.
Because they know you the greatest, so listen.
Bring it out.
And thine eyes shall look.
Bring it from the top again.
Bring it up.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Our sons and daughters given to another people during slavery. That's a curse. Read.
And thine eyes shall look at
them. You was gonna look. Read.
And fail with longing for them all the day long.
That you was gonna want your children back. They said your eyes was gonna look and fail with longing for them. Could you imagine? The white man come and get you, taking you, and you never, your mother or father never seen you again.
Bring
your eyes was gonna look and fail with longing for your children all what?
All the day long.
You ever seen 12 years a slave, that woman just sit on the porch and she cried.
Bring
she cried, because she wanted what? Her kids back.
Bring
it was a curse God said for our disobedience, these things were gonna happen.
That's right,
and there shall be no might in thing by in hand.
But there wasn't going to be no might, no power in our hands to do what? To get our children back.
That's right.
Just right now, we can fast forward to 2017.
Bring it over.
That's the juvenile detention center right now, all right? I even got family over there in that joint right now, all right? So if the white man took all these kids and put them over there in the juvenile detention, guess what you got to do to get them back? You got to go to court. Read that part again.
Work. And thy eyes shall look with better was longing for them all the day long.
You can cry, Lord, please, might take my baby. Read.
And there shall be no might in thine hand.
We ain't got no might in our hands to get our children back right now.
That's right.
Word. Read.
The fruit of the land and all thy labor shall like nations which thou knowest not eat up.
It said the fruit of our land that another nation was going to eat up. Meaning that you was going to plant, but you was not going to what? Benefit. All right, give me verse, give me 47. Huh? Now, give me 47. I want y'all to understand something. All right, listen.
Verse 47. Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with brokenness and gladness of the heart.
Hold on. You understand this, sister? They said because we didn't want to do what?
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart.
Now, we don't want to serve God with joyfulness and gladness of heart. Understand that. I'm showing you how we got in this predicament. And then I'm showing you in a minute how to get out of it. Alright, listen.
For the abundance of all things.
Now, we don't want to go to God for the abundance of all things. Alright, listen.
Therefore shall thy serve thine enemy.
Now we got to go serve who?
Thine enemy.
Do you understand what we just read? What did it just say? Somebody explain it. Alright, he says, why disobedience? We didn't want to do what God said do. He said, now you got to go serve your enemy. I want you to understand something when I read this. He didn't say your friends. He said your what? Your enemies.
That's right. Therefore shall thy serve thine enemy.
We got to go serve our enemies.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
He sent our enemies against us. Packers on slave ships. Read.
In hunger.
Now you got to go to your enemies in hunger. So if you get hungry, sister, I'll show you how we know that we the Israelites. Because we got to go to our enemies when we get hungry. You go to Walmart, who's trying to Walmart for groceries? Everybody, who going to Walmart?
Bring it up.
Our enemy. Who like McDonald's? Absolutely not. But who on McDonald's? Double O piece. Cola. Our enemies own those.
That's right.
Now our friends. Since 2017, we have been tricked, bamboozled, hoodwinked into believing that our enemies are our friends.
That's
why our people are shooting and killing. We think each other enemies. So the Bloods and the Crips, the G's and the Vice Lords are shooting one another, gunning them down.
What?
They won't lay a finger on the real enemy.
That's right!
They won't go to Master House.
Say it.
They ain't gonna break your Master House, they'll break your house and steal what you've been working for.
What?
But they will
bring
not break your Master House and steal his, he got 99-inch TVs in his house.
What?
But they won't do that.
Bring it out, huh?
$1,000 lamps. Right. They ain't gonna break in there and do that.
Bring it out! Bring it out!
Your gun room. They'll steal your house. They'll break your house, steal your 9mm out front of your pillow.
T-chop!
If a white man got a whole shelf full of guns in this house, they would not break in their slave master house.
Bring it
out! Go back to the scripture, read.
And in thirst.
They say you gotta go to your enemies for food and thirst.
What?
Meaning what? If you get thirsty, now you gotta go to your enemies for your disobedience, sister.
That's right.
So, to pay your water bill, who you gotta pay it to? The enemy. If you want some Dasani, you gotta pay it to your enemy.
What?
If you want a Coca-Cola, you gotta pay it to your enemy. Pepsi. If you might want to get a little sip yourself. You might want some Jack Daniels or something.
That's right.
Who on that?
The enemy.
You might want some Hennessy. I know y'all like Hennessy. Alright, single gene. All praise. Alright? So, you might want, you gotta go to your enemies for a thirst and what else?
And in the nakedness.
And nakedness, meaning that if you want clothing, you gotta go to your enemies. Ralph Lauren, Levi, Nike, even to get the raw textile to make this beautiful dress, okay? The people who made it had to go to their enemy to get it, okay?
That's right.
Alright? I want y'all to understand, I'm showing you how we know that we are the Israelites, that we are God's chosen people.
That's right.
We gotta repent these curses. We gotta go to our enemies. Listen.
And in want of all things.
So we gotta go to our enemies for the want of all things.
Right.
You want an education? Guess what school system you gotta go through? Our enemies. The enemy tricked us into us in our schools now and integrated them. Martin Luther King tricked us. I'm gonna tell you straight. Martin Luther King tricked us into integrating with them. Because we had our own school system. But guess what? We wanted to be so much like the white man. We said we're gonna close our school system down. And now we're gonna go to their school system. Now 2017, they can teach your children that there's no gender.
That's right.
Bring it out. They go in the little girls' bathroom now. And the little girls can go in the boys' bathroom now. Teach your kid oral sex in the kindergarten right now. They can teach your little boy how to run up in another little boy's rectum in the first grade now.
We
be integrated with them. We had our whole school system. That's why they took the Bible out of school, because we're reading right now.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Alright? It's saying this enemy, where they gonna be crying at? This same man was gonna do what? Hold it up so they can see it.
Here we go.
It said, and he, this is the truest knowledge on earth, man.
That's right.
Everybody should have their kids over here listening right now.
Here we go.
Well, I know why. Because we read, don't nobody want to hear it.
Right.
But we was over here singing, had the Mississippi Mass Choir out here, Kurt Franklin, y'all
were
dancing and doing the name.
Shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
It said, and this enemy was gonna put yoke of iron upon my neck.
What?
You see that system? Who put that on our necks? We can't remember. We can't forget that this was on our necks. That's why you see black on black crime, because this was on our necks. That's why we don't own the stores and opportunity, because why? This was on our necks for hundreds and hundreds of years. All right. I'm showing our people that we are the Israelites. We are God's chosen people.
That's right.
We are not alphas. We are not omegas. We are not no sigmas. We are the Israelites.
Yes.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.